Hello friends, welcome to Environment and Us. So, how is plastics totally ruining the oceans in the worst way possible? How the natural habitats of the marine animals are getting devastated day by day? Are we humans directly responsible for this devastation? What if we humans also face the same habitat crisis? Putting all these questions forward, let's begin today's video and try to understand these problems one by one. With increased urbanization and industrialization, plastics have become an integral part of our daily life, as a result of which, polymer is produced at a massive rate, which is deadly and detrimental for the health of our environment, especially for the marine environment. Since 1960, plastics has been slowly accumulating in the marine environment. Now we have huge masses of plastics floating in the ocean. If we are talking about the deadly effects of plastic, first we have to know what are the basic types of plastic waste that are polluting the ocean. So starting from the plastic bottle, which has the life cycle of 450 years, to the plastic bags, to the coffee cups and many more. So far, we have seen the types of plastic waste that are accumulated in the ocean. Now, moving on to the next part, where the question arises, what are the major sources of the generation of plastic waste? So, if you look at the sources of the plastic waste generation, the major source is packaging, and which constitutes about 59% of the total waste. So, lots and lots of plastic are used in packaging, followed by non-packaging household, which constitutes about 4%, 5% of construction and demolition waste, electrical and electronic equipments 8%, automotive 5%, 5% of agricultural and 14% of others. So around 60% of waste is actually on packaging. We need to focus on this and try to reduce the packaging material. Now let's see the production of plastic with the help of this graph. This graph is showing the increased amount of global plastic waste production from 1917 to 2017. In 1950, the world produced only 2 million tons per year. Since then, annual production has increased nearly 200-fold, which crossed 400 million tons in 2017. If you look at the global map, here we can see different colors have been given in terms of mismanaged plastic waste. The dark blue color identifies more in the numbers, that is greater than 5 million tons of plastic waste. The lighter shade represents less number of plastic waste production. As we can see, the highest number is for China, then the India and Pakistan. The numbers are low in some European countries and some countries in South America. That means there are lots of mismanaged plastic which are getting from different countries finally to the ocean. In the ocean, there are several whirlpools of water which trap huge collections of waste in their current, and that is called as the gyre. The ocean currents make the plastic back to the gyre. When the garbage enters the gyre, it's slowly pulling the center. Then this is formed as huge garbage patch. So there are total 5 garbage patches which are located in North Pacific, South Pacific, North Atlantic, South Atlantic and Indian Ocean. Among them, the biggest garbage patch is North Pacific garbage patch. In these areas, the plastics are floating around and making a circle, and these patches contain a huge collection of plastic. Here we are talking about the rate of plastic waste production. Which country is the highest plastic waste generator and the sources of plastic waste? Now we have to understand how the plastic waste are flowing from the land and accumulating into the ocean. Here we have some land-based sources Over 80% of the annual input comes from the land-based sources, which includes wastewater treatment plant, the day-to-day activities and etc. So from this, we are getting 0.5 million tons of plastic waste. Then there are some land-based coastal sources. It is estimated that 9 million tons of plastic waste is going into the ocean from the beach activity. Then we have microplastic, primary microplastic, which account 0.95 million tons of plastic waste. The remainder comes from the plastic released at the sea. The majority as a result of fishing activity, such as due to lost and discarded fishing gear. So from the fishing litter, we are getting 1.15 million tons of plastic waste per annum. And from the shipping litter, we are getting 0.6 million tons of plastic waste from annum. So 12.2 million tons of plastic waste are entering into the marine environment. We have discussed about this side, which are talking about where do they come from. Next, we are moving to this part, which is talking about where do they go. So 5% of the total plastic waste end up in the beach soil. The ocean surface is getting 1% of the total plastic waste. Maximum percentage of plastic waste are at sea floor. Total 94% of plastics are ultimately getting into the sea floor. So we have seen it's a huge impact of the plastic pollution in the ocean. The most significant part of today's lesson is the effects of plastic pollution on the marine animals. In most of the lessons, we are getting facts and figures of plastic waste generation and its effect, but not about the reasons behind the death of marine animals. The major cause of damage to marine animals is the physical wound or the entrapment or entanglement. The fish and marine birds becoming entangled in the things like plastic bags, the rings of plastic drink bottle, this can cause painful wounds. The birds, mammals, reptiles that live in sea still need air to breathe, can become so entangled that they cannot take oxygen and ultimately die. The other major danger of plastic in our ocean is that it's often mistaken for food and eaten up by the marine animals. Instead of food, they consume the plastics, which can choke them and cause internal injuries or slowly starve them to death. And the chemicals which are present in the plastics also affect the life of the marine animals. The fish and other marine animals take in water through their gills and increasingly face risks from minute particles of plastic debris. Intestinal injury. The fishes fail to move or escape when entangled into plastic and get wounded by the plastic rings and ropes, which give rise to infection and death. The countless sea turtles are injured or die each year as a result of entanglement in synthetic commercial fishing nets or other types of plastic pollution. Like the other marine species, sea turtle also ingests small plastic debris. Swallowing plastic waste may obstruct the turtle's digestive system and can lead to death. The marine debris injures or kills countless seabirds every year. One of the most affected species is the Laysan albatross. Studies have estimated that up to 98% of the Laysan albatross swallowed plastic debris, which can obstruct their digestive system. Plastic pollution also adversely impacts the pelicans and the gulls. Plastic have become found to kill coral reefs also, which are an essential part of our ocean ecosystem and home to thousands of species. Plastics carry bacteria. Plastic blocks the light and oxygen from getting into the corals.
Now, let's discuss some facts and figure of plastic pollution and its detrimental effects on marine life. Here I have given some solid facts and figure which not only make you aware about the plastic pollution but will also give some glimpse of its deadly effects on the marine life. You can see that the plastic constitutes approximately 90% of all the waste floating on the ocean's surface, with 46,000 pieces of plastics per square mile. We produce 1 lakh chemicals commercially, all of which enters the ocean through transport accident and leaking into the soil and reaching to the ocean. 5.25 trillion pieces of plastic waste estimated to be in our ocean. See that more than 1 million seabirds and 1 lakh marine animals die from plastic pollution every year, and 100% baby sea turtles have plastic in their stomach. The fish we consume, that 1 in 3 fish caught for human consumption contains plastic. Between 8 to 14 million tons of plastic enter into our ocean every year. Fish in the North Pacific ingest 12,000 to 24,000 tons of plastic each year. 165 million tons of plastic currently circulates in Earth's marine environment. So friends, that's all for today. Hope you like this video. So don't forget to subscribe my channel for more learning videos and comment below if you like it. Thank you.